Welcome to the show. It's time to have fun again. Today we're going to be building up AMT's perennial, the iconic PT-109, John F. Kennedy's patrol boat from World War II. He was on this boat. Now, if every man, there's a running joke, if every man who claimed they were on PT-109 with John F. Kennedy was actually on PT-109, it would have had to have been two separate aircraft carriers instead of just a patrol boat. This box is pretty cool. They've got some nice black and white images of our former president on there. It's got some history of the PT-109 you can read, and it's got this really, really nice Pacific box art of the PT-109 in action. This is a reissue. I'm pretty sure it's from the Lindbergh molds, if I remember correctly, and maybe even before that. The manual is also really cool. It's got a lot of writing on there, tells you more about the ship, and then it goes through with actual pictures of the assemblies. All the parts number are listed. So these are different than what you'd normally see, and I thought you guys would get a kick out of that and seeing what this will be like when you pick up your copy. Being an older kit, of course, it's got some caveats, but hey, I love vintage kits, and that's why I wanted to build this one on the show. We've got all kinds of interesting stuff in the box. We've got vinyl printed flags, and that allows us to fold and bend those much easier. They are stickers in this version. And then it has actual water slide decals for the instrumentation in the wheelhouse. PT-109 emblems. Also different callouts. You can see all the different callouts on there, so you can just slice it after the PT and make whatever PT boat you wish and whatever numeration you desire. You don't have to build PT-109. In the box, there are two bags full of parts, and there's a lot of loose stuff, so watch that when you're emptying out the bags. We've got our rudder here, and a lot of the design of this makes me think this was originally a battery-powered model. Got some small parts there. Everything is molded in this dark green. We've got small figures so you can tell the scale of the ship. This one has arms with half of binoculars. They've all got life jackets on. We'll get to paint those up quickly. We got little wheels, storage containers, vents. We got the torpedo tubes. We've got more vents on there. We've got some cockpit areas. All the armor is down, so you could cut those and hold them open if you wished. On this tree here, we've got more torpedo tubes. We've got the captain's wheel. We've got small, oh, we got a life raft. That's awesome. We got some rescue rings. Check those out. I am absolutely amazed that those aren't full of flashing. We got some very, very fine metalwork there. Propeller. Then the testing the durability of the plastic. Definitely makes me think this had battery poweredness in it. We got our turret there. We've got more cabin area or engine deck possibly. Not a PT-109 expert. I'm not a patrol boat expert, but I sure want to build this kit, and that's all that's needed. We've got our mast here, nicely thin molded vents. You don't have to, if you want to, you can drill those out or just paint them black. Works just as well. We've got machine guns. Little turret gun there. We've got a nice display stand. Great that it comes with that. And it doesn't say PT-109 on it. It says Torpedo Elco Boat from the Electric Company. The Electric Boat Company. So you can decorate that. You don't have to worry if you're not building PT-109. And then check out the size of this boat. There's our deck. Nice and big. We got anti-slip texture molded in. We got some molded in anchors. We can hand paint all that. That is really cool. Bottom side's got large tabs to locate it in place. A little bit of flash in certain areas. Just slice that off with your knife. And then the big hull. It's a one-piece hull. It's got a nice keel on it. It's got this bump out, which again, with that, those parts there, just knowing RC, see this mount right here and all these little interior mounts. This had to have been where batteries and a motor was mounted. And then you've got your stuffing tube would come out, your rudder, which would have had a little arm to turn it. Yep, definitely think this was RC at one point. Or you could make it radio control or just battery operated. So that's pretty cool, and it does seem pretty straight. The deck we will have to probably clamp into place, but it does sit flush, and it's very thin, so it should go into place. It's going to use a good amount of glue, high quality model glue, and we should get that to line up and hold in place, and then we'll press the center down, just loosely centers down. Once I clean up a lot of that flash and molding relief, we'll get that to hold down. In fact, what I'm probably going to do is put that top down, run a bead of glue, and then press it down on there, put a few dozen books on top and hold it flat. So I'm gonna start to build mine my way, and I will be right back. Thank you. We all know how the super famous song goes, She's Real Fine by PT-109. That's right. That's the song, right? PT-109, that's what it's about, right? Well, anyways, so we've got the boat assembled. We are set to start hitting it with paint now on this one because it's pretty much one color except for the very bottom of the hull. I did assemble most of the ship like I do with a lot of military models. I did leave some stuff out that I want to do in different colors and add accents to. I want to do the lifeboat in pretty much the same color, but the brackets I want to highlight and I want to do some washing inside there and stuff like that. These parts would be used to mount a motor in the hull, I'm pretty sure. They're not mentioned, so I didn't even, you know, I just left them on there. The rescue rings I will do in a white per the instructions and then glue them on. We'll get some wash in there, make them look nice, do some rope around there, and that little life raft. The propeller and the wire, I think this was supposed to be antenna wire, but that's way too thick for me to be antenna wire, so we'll find something else for that kind of stuff. So I super glued that on there. We've got the machine guns and the masts and everything right there, so we'll get those painted up on their own trees and attach those at the very end so I don't break them off. The rudder, so that when I'm moving the hull around and messing with stuff, the rudder just pushes in with a friction fit. So I will get that painted the same color as the hull, but I won't install it until the very end so I can lay the ship down on my bench and I can work on it and detail it. You can see how nicely that all goes together. The multiple holes allow you to get this rail in without it snapping straight. Got our hatches in place. Of course, you can paint things separately and do that, but we got our vents in. We've got the mounts for the torpedoes. We can do those up. We got our other vents. We got the machine gun mount and that little tiny wheel that goes on it. There are some stanchions, these little itty bitty holes here. These five holes and two in the back. They are four. Once we started assembling, it told me. These little ringlets here. All right. So we will paint those, we will cut them out gently, we will install them almost at the very end of the model, and then we will provide, it says, the manual says provide your own thread, we will provide our own thread to run through those as guide wires, as railings around the boat. We've got our torpedo mounts, and these thin plastic rods mount on the outside, and I model glue those in so that they hold. We've got various cleats, and these they look like kind of cleats, but they would actually be for like running lines from the cleats out to the edges and probably towing things, dragging things behind them that they would require. We got our exhaust off the back like we should. We've got all of our machine gun turrets installed. We can paint it all up and then we can start doing some fading and a little weathering. I don't want this to be a brand new boat, but I want it to look nice, and that's what it will. The stand goes together super easy. Instead of trying to force each side of the stand in, I just put it in sideways like you saw and snapped it in place and then glued it. That's going to get painted up, probably a black color. And then we'll see if I can't use some of the decals at the end to accentuate it. The torpedo boat, the Elco logo, are prominent, but I'm not sure that I can get a marker on those without bleeding. We'll see. If I can't, I can just paint over it. The figures, these two figures have their arms pre-installed, so those are ready to go. I did have to detach these two guys to glue their arms on. The one with the binox and the one that will be running the machine gun off the back of the hull. Those guys are set. We can just put them in some stick-em and get them painted. And I definitely want to paint the figures. It gives us a sense of scale of the ship. You saw the ship's wheel and those stanchions. Those will get painted on their trees and installed later. We got the torpedo tubes. I did not want to attach those. I want these to be a little, stand out a little bit from the ship, a different color green that I will then work on and fade, but I want them to be newer. The directions show you that the three lines that are close together, then you have the two and the one, the three lines that are close together should have this cap with this little addition on here. So if you want to assemble them in the correct manner, and then those will get placed on the hull. When we're all done, those will get super glued into place back there on that ship. So there's not a lot of parts now. We're going to paint that hull as one piece. Then I will mask it around. And then I will spray that bottom a nice hull red color. And we will get to painting everything right now. Anchors away, my boys, anchors.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
After a relaxing 2 days, this kit builds very, very easily, paints up easily. I did, in case you notice it in the pictures on the upper deck, I had some weird reaction between the primer and paint that's never happened before. I think I got a bad can of primer, so I tossed that one in the trash. I had a little crackle when the paint went on the top. Happens every once in a while when you get a bad can of primer or I didn't shake it enough. I managed to cover it up with the weathering and the dry brushing so you really can't tell anymore. But on some of the pictures, they are higher resolution than the video. You'll probably pick that up a little bit. But the kit itself, easy to build, and when you're done, very, very easy to tell exactly what ship it is. It's John F. Kennedy's PT-109, but of course with the included decal sheet, you can make any PT boat that you would like and design it. I went with PT-109 because I'm going to be giving this to someone that is JFK's generation and they will definitely enjoy it. I did the torpedo tubes in a contrasting color, figuring they would not always match the PT boat. Rusted up the exhaust on the back a little bit. Did that red hull. Otherwise, just did some shadow work, a little metal, where they rub rails and stuff like that. Ran the lines. And we have that done. Now, when I tried to run the lines through the little eyelets, the holes are small. I tried drilling them out by hand, and I broke one of them, which left me one short. There's only six. That's exactly the amount you need. So I used four on the front and just glued the wire or the sewing thread that I used to the top of them. On the back, as you saw in the construction video, I did just use the pins, metal pins, painted them green, and use those on the back with the wire. It looks absolutely fine, and that wire does add a little bit of feature. Also, something I probably got wrong, because I'm not in the Navy, so I don't know how they work, and I wasn't about to learn flag communication just to build a PT boat, because I'm not all that worried about it, but the instruction manual, the flags in the instruction manual are right there, don't match anything in the decal sheet. Neither do the ones there, neither do the ones on the box top. So I didn't know what to put where. So I knew exactly where one flag went, the American flag off the stern. And then I just said, well, we're going to put those pretty flags on the mast and on the bow. And that is it. And then I'm just not going to worry about it. I did the men, the sailors, and the lifeboat, and the torpedo tubes in a contrasting color of green, just to show a different age or a different style of material, whether they go through heat or whatever. I painted the tips red because that matches the box top and the instructions, so I did that, and then I darkened out the back of the torpedo tubes, did the rescue rings in white as they requested on the instructions, and laid our numbers on there. The instructions, the only numbers the instructions mentioned or showed on the entire assembly, we're placing the PT-109 emblems on the bow there, and that is what I did on mine. I'm sure if a person wanted to, they could research the PT-109. There's got to be a billion research papers done on this ship and get that more perfect, but that's how I did mine. And I really like it, and I know the person I give it to will like it. I've got one machine gun off to the left, and the machine gun in the back with the two men working it, and then the figures with the binoculars and the driver on the wheel. I'm glad they included the dash details, and then we've got all of our other details on the ship. I think it's a nice looking model. It comes out very nice. Of course, it's an older model, so it's very easy to build, and it has the potential for a lot of super detailing for the experts on the ship. But if you want a nice looking PT-109 and a good time, I highly recommend this ship. It'll be an easy build for any builder. You will enjoy it. And that is all I care about in the hobby. As always, thanks for watching the workshop for today's Wednesday build video. We will see you Saturday with an all-new kit. Talk to you then.